And to come back and to just see the state of affairs, I think at the onset, if I'm being honest, it was just devastating.
Meghan Markle's move back to the United States came at a difficult time in the country, and it emotionally affected her. The Duchess of Sussex got candid about her feelings coming back to America during an in-depth conversation with Emily Ramshaw, the co-founder and CEO of the news organization The 19th. Their chat covered a wide range of important topics, including the pandemic, the state of journalism, and the Black Lives Matter movement. And at one point, Emily asked Meghan what it was like to return to her home country amid mass protests surrounding the deaths of countless Black people. As Meghan explained, she hadn't been permanently living in the US for quite some time. She lived in Canada for 7 years working on suits before her move to the United Kingdom. So returning at a time like this made even more of an impact.
It was so sad to see where our country was in that moment. And if there's any silver lining in that, I would say that in the weeks that were happening after the murder of George Floyd, in the peaceful protests you were seeing, in the voices that were coming out, in the way that people were actually owning their role and acknowledging their role that they played either actively or passively in the discrimination of other people, specifically of the Black community.
That silver lining started to come through even stronger for Meghan, so much that she gained a new perspective.
It shifted from sadness to a feeling of absolute inspiration because I can see that the tide is turning. And I think for so many of us, it's very easy to focus on the negativity. It's very easy to focus on that because it's what you hear.
Meghan pledged to be a part of this renewed push for change and to keep speaking up, hinting that foregoing her senior royal role and moving to the United States has allowed her to use her voice differently.
To see the changes that are being made right now is really, it's something that I look forward to being a part of and being a part of using my voice in a way that I haven't been able to of late. So yeah, it's good to be home.
Meghan also talked about voting and revealed that she'd recently been talking to feminist icon Gloria Steinem about just that. She stressed that people shouldn't underestimate the importance of being able to cast a ballot and used her husband, Prince Harry, as an example.
I think it's often challenging for men and women alike, but certainly for people to remember just how hard it was to get the right to vote and to be really aware of not taking that for granted. I mean, I look at that, my husband, for example, he's never been able to vote. And I think it's such an interesting thing to say the right to vote is not a privilege, it is a right in and of itself,